Sweet old, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home.
Before it goes boom, blah, how you like America now? Babylon the Great, so foul, terror, full-blown terror, spreading like gossip on Gerardo Rivera. Terror, devil to step to the Israelite zone, but they all get enslaved with the scriptures, baby, it's on. We too strong to have a march like a poo, but I'd rather feel my sword to your guts. I'm nuts. For the truth and the knowledge of the Bible, when fucking red devils for survival with your heart shy. Oh, you forgot about Christ, you crooks. Enslaved as holy people with a good book you took. Mercy, mercy, you was bloodthirsty. Now you wanna go to heaven first, see, but pardon me. While the angels and you call UFOs are beaming us up, you gon' get struck with the bomb.
Right, right, right. To invade with the troops, America get ready to be bombed with the nukes. And it's God. Right, right, right. To invade with the troops, America get ready to be bombed with the nukes. And it's God.
And so, as we say goodbye to our dark friends and neighbors,
America, get ready to be bombed with the fire in the sky. America, get ready to be bombed with the fire in the sky. America, get ready to be bombed with the fire in the sky.
Shalom, brothers and sisters. Welcome to another live edition of The Hidden Truth. I'm your host. I'm Priest Kazakia. We're the Israelite School of Biblical History and Practical Knowledge. We're located here in Houston, Texas. And thank you for tuning in. We're here every Tuesdays at 8:30, so you can tune in online. Check us out if you want to go to the live stream and check this out if you're out of town. It's at HMSTV, Houston Media Source. com. You can go there, click on the live link, and check us out live. Come and see us. Join our classes Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays, and Saturday morning classes. And also, we have our Ustream. If you're out of town or out of the country, you can join us on that also. Once again, we're here with Priest Tahawan Mayam.
Shalom, brothers and sisters.
We're here with Priest Ahab.
Shalom, brothers and sisters.
And Priest Tazadat.
Shalom, brothers and sisters.
There you go. And we like to say shalom to the brothers, our comrades out in San Antonio, Kawakab, Meshaba, Banabad, and I also say a special shalom to Yeshaya, Priest Yeshaya. We like to say shalom to those brothers doing the work in Christ, okay? So today's topic, we're going to be talking about the mind state that we should be in during these last times, because we have a lot of, there's so much confusion. So much chaos when you deal, especially with a lot of the new generation. There's a lot of people that's created so much confusion for the youth, for the young brothers and sisters coming up in the truth. So, you know, this topic and this show is about kind of putting things in perspective and where our mind should be. Because, you know, dealing with different topics and subjects and themes in the scriptures, you find out that when you go to YouTube, you go on Facebook or, you know, on these media sites or these websites, you know, brothers in certain topics, they might have little disagreements. Our one goal is when you look at all the Israelites scattered through the four corners is to teach Israel to raise Israel up. But when we get to, you know, maybe a topic here, a topic there, might be a little disagreement on these topics. So, you know, this show is about kind of putting things in perspective for those young brothers and sisters. And, you know, if brothers that been here doesn't understand, they should understand this show right here.
Right, right. And, you know, especially for those ones that, you know, they're what we call Facebook scholars, you know what I mean,
right.
YouTube scholars. You've been getting your education off of YouTube.
Right,
you know what
right.
I mean, you've been getting your education off of what you see on Facebook. And that's, you really want to be, you want to be in a camp, you want to be at a school
right.
where you have a structure. YouTube and Facebook does not provide a structure.
Right,
that's
right.
the problem. Mm. You can go on there and find beautiful videos.
Right, right.
You can find beautiful knowledge on there, but the problem is if you don't know, if you're not anchored, if you're not sure, then you're going to be on there scatterbrained, and you're going to be looking into everything, And right, a lot, right. Some of that stuff's put up there to disseminate that knowledge. It's to,
right.
to dissipate that knowledge and make it look like it wasn't worth anything.
Right.
So
right.
There's a lot of doubt.
We got
scoffers.
There's a lot of that right now. Yeah. There's a lot of that right now, and I'm not gonna say totally from Israelite brothers, but there's a lot of that them trying to destroy that unity, that brotherhood,
right.
And you know, Satan trying to do his work and cause confusion and chaos.
Exactly.
And I see it. I feel sad because I talk to a lot of young brothers and sisters, and they're tossed to and fro with every wind of doctrine, and they don't have any focus,
right?
You know, on really where their mind should be at.
Yeah.
You know, but you know, talking about the YouTube generation and everything, you know, if you don't get into school, you don't get in a class and do what the scriptures say, the unity, the brotherhood, forsaking, gathering yourself together, you might think that, you know, if you're looking at all street speaking videos, you might think, oh, that's how they teach.
Right.
They don't understand that there's a classroom environment and there is a street speaking environment. You know, you don't get brothers street speaking the same way they teach in class.
Right.
It's a whole different environment. It's more one-on-one and it's more dealing with your spirit as opposed to now you're dropping a color and things to really kind of dig in and get you to think.
Right.
Class is more of that spiritual, that inward man. So, you know, that's why we always point out, we always talk about getting into class, getting into school. You know, and I said it and I'll say it again, it's not necessarily our school, but there's a lot of brothers out there doing the work of the Most High, sincere, you know what I mean? And you'll know who they are because they're not trying to divide. They're not trying to cause division. They're not trying to go back and forth. You know what I mean? It shouldn't be about that.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, but in today's topic, what are we going to be touching on?
Well, first of all, if you can grab me Zephaniah 2:1. The thing is, you know, we know our main goal. We got to gather together.
Right.
You know what I mean? As a nation. You see the 12 tribes chart. Every time we put that up there, whether you believe all of them are the nation or not.
Right.
You know what I mean? We're talking about all those scattered throughout the world and specifically these people.
Right.
That we need to gather together. We need to get together. And we see these times is getting rough.
Let me add this to this, because this is something that me and High Priest Yeshaya talk about a lot. And it's not saying that we or one camp is going to gather the whole nation.
Right.
You understand? That's not what we're saying. What we're saying is that the beginning of this gathering, because we know the gathering is going to come through Christ.
Right.
The reaping, the getting all the brothers and sisters that are scattered through the four corners of the earth is only going to happen with Christ to the fullness is what we're talking about.
Right, right.
To the fullness that it's going to happen. So what we're doing is just the beginning stages.
Right.
We're just laying the little, you know, touches on what Christ is going to do ultimately. So, you know, just setting things in perspective because, you know, some brothers really think that we're going to gather everybody together.
Right.
No, this is just the beginning stages and Christ is going to put the icing on the cake, you know?
Right, right. No, exactly. And that's the thing is we got to, you know, at least be perfectly joined together in the same mind, same body. And that's only going to come when we start seeing the signs of the times, when we start seeing what's going on in the world. Why are all these writings? Why are all these things that Christ said, the wars, the rumors of wars,
right.
The earthquakes, these natural disasters? We're seeing all these things, all the signs of the times coming. How are we supposed to be thinking at that time?
Right. All those things that destroy that ideal that the Bible was written by man.
Right.
That the Bible ain't true. The Bible's a comic book.
Right.
Look at the facts, and we have to step back and look at what prophecies are happening.
Right.
Right.
Yeah. And as we see them coming to pass, we got to know is this the mindset we're supposed to be on? That okay, I'm gonna bicker over what I think this scripture says, and
right.
Those aren't talking about black people, and you know what I mean?
Right.
Is that what we're supposed to be fighting about, or should we be out in the streets making sure our people have at least some basis, you know what I mean, to form a unity and form a brotherhood,
right.
And be able to go out there and reach them and help them teach and guide their families.
Right, right.
See
right.
that? So that's the kind of scriptures we're going over is, are we going to get our priorities straight? Are we going to get our mindset together in these last days and times? Are we going to start acting like we can just be scatterbrained, and I'm going to believe in Egyptology, and I'm going
to,
you know.
Because that's what it's coming down to.
Right.
Yeah. That's what it's coming down to, and that's why, you know, YouTube and the internet is all good, but also you see how that the devil, I'm going to use that word, the devil, okay, is used that to keep, bring more chaos and confusion. You know, like I said, you can see it through a lot of young brothers and sisters that is like, well, I was told this, I was told that, I was told this. It's like, well, how do you know the person or the individual that told you wasn't some dang FBI agent? You know what I mean?
Right, right.
So how do we know and how do we decipher from these things? You know, because there's a lot of that going on, too.
Oh, yeah.
We talk about that a lot. You know, it's a lot of brothers that somebody was telling me about one cat. He don't show his face. He don't show his face. He don't show anything. He just says he's an Israelite, but he's just going against everything.
Every kind of doctrine.
Yeah, everything. Right. You know what I mean? And you're getting that.
Right. Yeah. You know, you see a lot of it.
You're getting a lot of it. So, like we said before, it's like it ain't necessarily real brothers.
Right.
That sincere. You know what I mean? And that know that this work is not about me, you. It's not about my ego. It's not about how many brothers I got in my camp or how many brothers you got in your camp. It's not about, I'm not going to join up with these brothers because I don't want my power to be taken away from me. You know, but it's about unity. It is about Christ.
Right.
It's about the gathering of brothers. You know what I mean? It's not about our egos, man.
Exactly.
You know, I know we can definitely go on this all day, but let's touch on these scriptures, man.
Well, yeah, get that first of all. Zephaniah 2, verse 1.
Zephaniah chapter 2, verse 1. Gather yourselves together. Yea, gather together. O nation, not desire.
Right. So this is our command, and this is what, you know, the main goal of us, you know, Israelite School of Biblical History and Practical Knowledge. We come out there, and we want people to gather together. We want our people, if they come to our class, if they come to another camp, if they go, whatever they do, if they're obeying this commandment, that they gather together. Yeah. Now, I want you to go to 3, verse 9, because I want to show just how we're supposed to be gathered together. Mm-hmm. And I'm going a little off of what I scheduled, but go ahead and read 3, verse 9.
Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 9. For then will I turn to the people a pure language.
Right, so the Most High is going to do that. So we'll all be, you know, of that one language.
So we don't have to fight about who has the correct Hebrew.
Yahuwah, Yahweh, Yahweh, Yeshua.
Right. We know that in the world when you call on the name of the Most High.
He heard you.
He heard you.
That's how you got the knowledge.
Right. Exactly.
Yeah, go ahead.
That they may all call upon the name of the Lord to serve him with one consent.
Right. Now, that word consent is talking about to be in concord in opinion or sentiment.
Right.
So that our feelings, our way of thinking, it would all be united. Mm. So this is what the goal is, that we want to be united, same mind, same judgment.
Right.
All right. Before, and, you know, if we go back to Zephaniah 2 and 1, I want you to read that one more time, because he wants us to gather together in one consent for a reason.
Right.
All right. So go back and read that.
Zephaniah chapter 2, verse 1. Gather yourselves together. Yea, gather together, O nation, not desire.
Go ahead.
Verse 2. Before the decree bring forth.
And this is the topic of our show, is before that decree comes down. Before he got to really lay down the law and lay down that hammer and say, you know what, the judgment is here.
Right.
You know, you go to court, that's the analogy I'm making. You go to court and they're going to sentence you. They're going to tell you you're going to get 15 to 20 years. She dropped that hammer down and boom, you in jail. Right. So the Most High is ready to drop that hammer on this earth. And he's been given the signs so that you can wake up, so that you can see, okay, this, I'm smoking weed and acting and putting my mind in a whole different mind state.
Right.
Let me get rid of that. Let me get my mind sober. Let me get it clear, like the scriptures say. Let me go ahead and obey the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High in Christ. Mm. Let me get my family in order, because Christ is coming and I'm gonna be accountable for them, because they've been being led by me. So these are the things the Most High wants us to wake up to. You know what I mean? Before that decree comes forth, then he got to lay that judgment down and say, you know what? I'm concluding all under sin.
Right. He said, right? right. He said, I shall send for many fishers and they shall fish them.
Right.
Then I will send for many hunters. You know, and we know the angels is going to be doing that. They're going to be putting a lot of people to death and bringing this, you know, the earthquakes, the famines, the wrath of these angry ass people just killing each other and and bombing each other and shooting each other. You know, they just jumped on sabotage these two cops in one of the states. You know, so now that's going down.
Right.
They're gonna start killing these cops. You know.
Yeah.
And you know, it's people that is just not walking with wisdom and knowledge, and we have to understand the signs and the times and what's going on.
Oh yeah. And even, you know, for our police brethren out there, y'all got to see the signs of the times too. The thing is, the Most High said it wasn't going to be the Israelites doing this. It said he's going to raise up a nation.
Yeah.
He's going to raise up a different type of people that don't care about all that, you know, you got a badge on, and they're going to start coming after y'all. So this ain't us doing this. This is the decree from the Most High being brought forth.
Yeah.
And it doesn't matter who you think you are. It's going to come down on all. When you read is it Galatians 3:22?
Yeah.
He said the scriptures have concluded all under sin.
Right, right.
You understand? So when he brings that decree down, he's going to those that have been are worthy of getting beaten with more stripes, right, they're going to get more stripes.
Well, go to Ezekiel 9:4 just right on that point. You know, and this goes with the unity, the gathering, how our mind is supposed to be, you know. And then I got another one on top of that. Go to Ezekiel 9:4 really quick.
Ezekiel chapter 9, verse 4. And the Lord said unto him, Go through the midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem,
right,
and set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and that cry.
Right. So this is the common theme that we're going to have.
Right.
You know, this is the common theme that the Israelites are going to have, the chosen.
Right.
We're sighing and crying. Go ahead.
For all the abominations that be done in the midst thereof.
We're looking at all the filth, the rape, the robbery, the murder, the police brutality, the drugs in our community. We're looking at the drug dealers. We're looking at how rap is destroying our people. We're looking at all these things, and we're sighing and crying for it.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
Go ahead.
Verse 5,
uh-huh.
And to the others he said in mine hearing, go ye after him through the city and smite.
Right, and this is what we're talking about. Right. We're talking about the Most High. If you look at the signs, the times, and you look at all the things that the prophecies coming to pass, he's smiting.
Right.
Through his wars, famines, pestilence, earthquakes, you know, all these things, just random killings is getting crazy.
Right, right. He's doing what the purge, all that stuff you think.
Right, right.
You know, the stuff you've seen in these movies, that's he's bringing that to pass.
Right.
And he's not just doing it, you know, through people. He's doing it through the natural disasters. He's doing it through these type of things.
Right.
And this is the decree from the Most High being brought forth.
Right, right.
All
right.
And for those that are like, you know, you sitting there, you thinking, okay, well, as I see him getting worse, you know, man, I'm going to do what I want to do all up until I see it getting worse. And I'm going to have just enough time where I can be like, oh, Jesus, I'm sorry.
Right, right.
I'm going to go ahead and repent then. Well, here's the thing. Read Amos chapter 5 and verse 18.
Right, right.
All
right.
Because it says before the decree come forth. Now, the decree is already being dropped now.
Right.
So some of y'all are a little too late, but you can still do it. He hasn't dropped that final axe.
Right, right. Right.
So what we're going to is, for you that are waiting for that day where you think you're going to get busy right then and you're going to jump on, you know, everything the Most High told you to do at that last minute, and then you're going to get in. Well, read that.
Amos chapter 5, verse 18. Woe unto you that desire the day of the Lord.
Right. He said, woe, destruction for you that desire that day.
Right.
That you're waiting for that last day where you think you're going to be just, oh, all of a sudden you're just going to just, oh, I'm sorry.
Right, right.
And I'm feeling holy right now. And Jesus, I accept you into my heart and all that. You're going to run to your churches and you're going to run to all these places and try to get religion at the last minute. He said destruction's going to come to you before you get that. Mm-hmm. He said, woe to you that desire the day of the Lord. Read.
To what end is it for you?
What good is that going to do for you? Right. You already going to be destroyed.
Right. And then what day is that prepared for you? You know, you know, us that desire the day of the Most High. You know, everybody wants Jesus to come back. Well, he's coming back. It's already started. He said, I will not meet thee as a man.
Exactly.
He said, I will not meet thee as a man. So in the earthquakes, in the tempest, in the storm, this is the beginning of him coming back till he actually shows his face.
Right.
You know, and these are the things, these are the signs and the times that the wise that we're looking out for, we're seeing.
Right.
You know what I mean? So let me get one just right with that. Go to 1 Corinthians 8, verse 1. 1 Corinthians 8, verse 1. And this is something we need to be careful. We need to really be careful and understand what's going on here, and how we can be easily distracted from the purpose of the Most High. Right. You know, and go read that 1 Corinthians 8:1. Read that.
1 Corinthians 8:1.
Uh-huh.
Now, as touching things offered unto idols,
right,
we know that we all have knowledge.
Right.
Knowledge puffeth up.
Right. And this is the point I'm trying to bring out here. Read it again.
Knowledge puffeth up.
Read.
But charity edifies.
Right. So, and this is where we go. You know, you got the earthquakes, you got the famines, you got the pestilence,
right,
you got the destruction, you got the uprising, you got people's brains being blown out in the movie theater. You got all these things.
Right.
But now you got brothers and sisters arguing about knowledge. You know what I mean? How, you know, about this breakdown or that breakdown. It's like, what's going to save you? What's going to save your soul?
Right. Is the knowledge of the giants from the time before and the right. Anunnakis and all these things.
Right.
Is that going to save you? Is that going to keep you in the right place at the right time when the bombs drop?
Because last time I looked, he said, when Christ comes back, he's going to ask you, have you fed my sheep?
Right.
Have you clothed them? Have you visited them in prison? Have you, you know, these things that pertain to what we're dealing with now.
Right.
You know
right.
what I mean? Not a breakdown or, oh, brother, you got that breakdown wrong or you got the understanding on this wrong. The Most High is not going to line us up and say, okay, did you get the Daniel 7 breakdown?
Right.
Okay, you're out of here.
Right.
Did you get the Revelations breakdown? Why are you breaking it down like that? You're out here. You're not going to, you know, okay, you took that wrong. He's going to look at your sincerity.
Right.
Your mm-hmm. spirit, your heart. You know what I mean? You're following those commandments and saying, okay, what I did know, did I follow that?
Right, right.
You know, and these are the things we got to remember, you know, as the world is coming to an end, or as this kingdom, excuse me, is coming to an end.
Right, because that's what I've been seeing, you know, all over Facebook. Christ wasn't a real person. And,
yeah.
You know, it's like, okay, well, what are you going to feed your kids with? He's the one that told you about the signs of the times.
Right.
You know what I mean? But you don't want to follow him. Okay, Esau's not the so-called white man. Okay, we did a show on it, gave you undeniable proof, literally,
right,
that he's that, and you want to deny that even then.
Right.
Okay, cool. So how's that going to save you?
Right, right.
That these brothers that were taught doctrine from way back and have been carrying that ancient landmark, we went ahead and removed that.
Right.
Okay, is that what you want to be caught doing when Christ comes?
Right, right.
That's what you want to be caught doing when the Most High put that decree? Because we're going Old Testament. We're not even talking Christ yet.
Right.
The Most High said he was going to bring a decree forth
right, right.
to end all this. So even if you didn't believe in Christ, if you want to deny that, the Most High is still showing you the signs of the times that he prophesied.
Right. That's why we got to be careful. It says knowledge puffeth up. But what?
But charity edifies.
That charity, is that love.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That love for the brotherhood, that love for your nation, that love for Israel. We went over this before, but we know in part, we prophesy in part.
Right.
It's going to come out. It's going to come out the things that we lack understanding on. But right now, how are we preparing spiritually? You understand? Right. How are you going to prepare? Because the things that's going to destroy you during these last times, as you get the earthquakes, the famines, and the lack of food, right? Mm-hmm. Go to Isaiah 33, verse 6 really quick. When as we come in these times, the lack of food, the lack of love, it says the land shall be barren of faith, right?
Right.
So as we come in these times, it ain't going to come down to a breakdown.
Right.
It's going to come down to, have you learned how to control your anger, your lust, your pride, your jealousy, your doubt? You know what I mean? All these things that the Most High is working on, that inward man.
Exactly.
You know, and that's what the scripture tells us here. Read it again.
Isaiah 33:6.
Uh-huh.
And wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times.
Right. So, but you say, well, knowledge puffeth up. Well, what wisdom and knowledge? It tells you charity. It tells you the love. That's what's going to keep us. It's going to be our stability. Because think about it. It's going to be when you don't got food on your table. And you haven't learned about faith, because all you did was rely on the easy way out,
mm-hmm.
right, to get your money, whether it's selling dope, drugs, or rather relying on the so-called white man. You never were put in a predicament to be or try your faith.
Right.
When those last days come, you're going to be the one running rampant and crazy, like a chicken with his head cut off, trying to figure out how to feed my kids.
Because you never learn how to control your own spirit.
But you had the breakdown.
Right.
But you had the breakdown.
You had the breakdowns, but you didn't have no brother there to check you and
there you go.
Discipline you and show you how to do things the right way.
There you go.
You know what I mean? Whether you had a breakdown or not, because you can't quote a breakdown to a bullet.
Right. You can't. In this instance, when you're hungry, faith is needed to be applied.
Right.
And you never learn that. The breakdown, the Daniel's breakdown or Esau being the so-called white man, that's all fine. That's knowledge.
Right.
And you need that.
Right.
But that's not going to help you.
Right.
That's not going to help you in the last times.
Right. Especially
if you don't
learn that.
This is what we're trying to show, brothers and sisters, because how much knowledge we got.
Right.
I mean, we all can go through knowledge.
Right.
You know, we all can go through breakdowns. You know, we go over the 12 tribes breakdown. We go over Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter. We're all for it.
Right.
But brothers and sisters have lost focus.
Right.
They have lost focus. They're getting too caught up into knowledge and not really understanding. You better have this unity.
Right.
Because, you know, one thing I love about our camp is that unity. We're striving, working together as a body.
Right.
And able to deal with each other, forgive each other. For each other's shortcomings for the last 10, 11 years.
Right.
You know what I mean? Because it says a brother's born through adversity. A breakdown in the last times ain't going to help me. What's going to help me is me learning, me understanding that brother that was with me.
Right.
And that he's not going to be the guy you know those movies that they're hiding canned foods
right.
from the other people. You know what I mean? Look at all these other reality shows
mm-hmm.
that they've done this with. You know, they put these people in this environment and it starts to bring out what type of individuals they are.
Right.
Yeah. We got to see that. The Esau or Edom breakdown, yeah, that's good. But what is really going to help my spirit in those predicaments?
Right. Yeah. It's going to be that ability to go ahead and give up of yourself, sacrifice, all the things that charity covers. That
patience,
love.
Kindness. Right. Long-suffering.
Right. You have to be able to give up on yourself and deal with another person, and
right.
it's not gonna come down to okay, if I quote this breakdown, will I be able to feed these kids or will I be? The breakdowns are good, the knowledge is good, you know what
yeah.
I mean? But it's just something to make you feel good. We're gonna have situations like this. Where's the breakdown gonna help you? Your love. The fact that you can grab onto that last person
right.
and not just be about yourself.
And then that's what I know that we have the Israelite school, even the brothers in San Antonio.
Mm-hmm.
I know I can go out there right now if I hunger, if I thirst, if I'm naked.
Mm-hmm.
I know those brothers and sisters will be there for me.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? And, you know, one thing that we do have to also bear witness to, these brothers, House of David,
mm-hmm.
you know how they try to do they did the little
like the summit, the gathering.
The summit thing,
yeah.
the gathering of all the camps. I like that.
Yeah.
That's beautiful. That's what Israel is supposed to be doing. Not like gang members and gangs and
right.
You about this. What you wearing? I got this breakdown. Like, brother, that's fine and dandy. But when it all comes down to it and we're walking past each other,
right.
What side are you going to be on? You going to be on the side of the people that killed the prophets?
Right.
Or you're going to be on the side that helped, that supported the prophets, that carried the cross of Christ.
Right. And that's what these guys really got to understand is that at that time, man, it's going to come down to, you know, what are you going to do for your people?
Right.
It's not going to come down to none of this other stuff. And you know, for the, you know, Torah only and all this stuff like that. Okay, cool. But what is that breeding in you? Are you teaching? Are you feeding anybody?
Right.
You know what I mean? Are you gathering these people together? Are you trying to gather with people that think like you? You know what I mean? So that, like, say this brother was going through your neighborhood. Can he walk through your neighborhood peacefully and you got his back? You
right.
know what I mean? And, or are you going to look at him and say, oh, okay, he does his fringes like this and we do our fringes like that. You a gang member. You
right,
know what I mean?
Right.
And Christ ain't coming back for that. The Most High is not dealing with that at the end.
Yeah.
He's going to be dealing with that charity, that love, and making sure that, okay, did you keep these commandments?
Yeah.
Did you keep the one? We got to remember, the biggest thing is that we're trying to not just get back to the law of Moses.
Right.
The law of Moses was for idiots. The scriptures say the law was a schoolmaster for little kids that was coming out of Egypt out of slavery in a slave mind state. Right. And they was trying to, they needed somebody to check them and say, stop committing these abominable acts that you used to do in Egypt.
Right.
But before that, righteousness was the law.
There you go.
Righteousness was Abraham got with Sarah. He wasn't like, yeah, I'm about to divorce this chick. She getting old and I ain't got no kids with her.
Right.
No, he stayed with her. He was righteous. It wasn't
without a law, without a law.
Right, without having to write her a bill of divorce or a bill of marriage or anything.
Right.
Righteousness was the law, and we're trying to get back to that. We're trying to get back to where what Paul was talking about, that we're not under the law, we're under grace. Why? Because we know the law so well that we just do it out of love. I'm going to make sure my brother is good. I'm going to make sure that I don't steal from him, rob from him. That's the law, but being acted out so that you're just righteous.
Right.
You know what I mean? And we're trying to get back to that. But if you still sitting here bickering over, you know, who Christ really came for because you heard a breakdown of who Christ did come for.
Right.
If you still bickering over who is the white man and who's not because you heard a breakdown that you didn't agree with and your white friend didn't you no more.
You know what? And that's why I go back to 1 Corinthians 14:44. 1 Corinthians 14:33. Okay. And this is a real good topic, a real good shot. It's not going in the direction we totally wanted it, but the Spirit is bringing it out. Read that, 1 Corinthians 14:33.
1 Corinthians 14:33.
Uh-huh.
For God is not the author of confusion.
Like, listen, when it all comes down to it, let's look at what's going on here.
Right.
Why is all this confusion being created? You know, yes. Yeah, I know what brothers are thinking. Well, this is the will of the Most High. You know, he said he was going to sever this from that, and it was going to, the word was going to cause it. Right. But read it again.
For God is not the author of confusion.
So we got to take both consideration of this scripture and the other ones.
Right.
So where is this confusion coming from? We got to understand what the Most High does and what the Satan does, too.
Right.
You see, right. Satan, Matthew 10:34, I came not to send peace on earth, but a sword, right? To divide mother from father, family, you know, father from son, right? We know that.
Right.
But what is this talking about? Read.
But of peace.
Right. It's showing you that Satan brings negative and confusion. Mm-hmm. We're supposed to be unifying, and we're supposed to be in this mind state of love of gathering Israel. Not talking about because you think this scripture or that scripture or this is wrong. That's not gonna bring us to the love, and that's what our point is.
Right, because we gotta understand this. Go to Matthew 13:25 real quick.
Yeah.
And we gotta understand where did the confusion come from?
Yeah.
Where did these type of mentalities come from? Where all of a sudden these doctrines are getting changed and all these things are getting changed? Those things we gotta just know that this is what happened. Read the words of Christ.
Right.
Matthew 13:25.
Mm-hmm.
Matthew 13:25. But while men slept, his enemy came.
His who?
His enemy came.
His friend came.
His enemy came.
All right. His bosom buddy.
His enemy came.
The Most High came.
His enemy came.
His enemy came and did what? Read.
And sowed tares among the wheat.
Right. So how did this confusion come? Is the enemy put all these things out there. They disseminated this knowledge and said, okay, Christ didn't exist. Oh, okay. Esau isn't the so-called white man. Okay. He disseminated all this knowledge. Now, what do you do when you got an enemy? You find people that got the same enemy. Who is that enemy against? He's against the people of the Most High in Christ.
Right.
It's since Psalms 83, since you read that,
you
should know that this enemy is against all Israel.
Right. He's the author of confusion.
Right. So, you know, just on that point is that we got to know that, okay, this is the enemy.
And
so,
that's what when we look at online. I'm sorry.
No, go ahead.
But that's what when we look at online, that's what brothers is failing to see. It's like, listen, it's another... Satan came in another way,
right?
And is trying to destroy another great unified nation,
right?
You understand? Mm-hmm. And that's why, you know, I always chop that madness down, because we're not Bloods, we're not Crips, we're not gang members,
right.
Brother, we're a nation of kings and priests, of wise men and women coming back to each other.
Exactly.
So that gang mentality, we got to throw that the hell out of there.
Yeah, it got to be,
you know,
a
that
family
thug
mentality.
It's like, brother, don't come to me with that.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Because we're not about that,
right.
You know, and that's what we're supposed to be about. That's what's going to establish this love, that brotherhood. You know, but that's on point, on point.
Yeah, we got to get back to that righteousness of the law.
You right.
know what I mean, the righteousness that the scriptures were trying to bring us, even through the law, through the prophets, is that we gotta get back together. We gotta gather ourselves together, gather together in the mind state of we have a common enemy right now. It ain't time to be bickering and playing games over little stupid nonsense.
Right, right.
We got a common enemy. When you watch America, they don't, you know, as much as they might differ over their religion, oh, I'm Catholic, I'm Jewish, I'm this, I'm that, they all get in the same damn green army and go stomp on some Iraqis or some Afghanis. You know what I mean? Because of what? Because they have a common, what they think is a common enemy.
Yeah.
So the thing is why can't Israel do that? Why is it, oh, they wear purple and gold on the street corners and we wear red and black. So, you know, now we can't gather
madness,
with them.
That's madness, man. Right. That's madness.
Right.
But it comes back to, what we're talking about is that we got bigger things to worry about.
Oh, yeah.
Not only Satan, but what is the Most High doing to show us that his word is true?
Right.
These earthquakes, these famines, these floods, these killings, all these things.
Exactly. Go back to Amos real quick, because this is the thing y'all doing is y'all bickering and fighting over these little points of knowledge. And the cats is going so deep as to like pick apart the word and in Hebrew and things like that. It's like, come on, man. Y'all bickering over this when the Most High is dropping this right here. Read Amos 5:18 again.
Right.
Amos 5:18. Woe unto you that desire the day of the Lord.
Go ahead.
To what end is it for you?
Read.
The day of the Lord is darkness and not light.
The day of the Lord is what?
Darkness and not light.
Sunshine and rainbows?
Darkness and not light.
Flowers and cotton candy?
Darkness and not light.
No, the day of the Most High is darkness and not light.
Right.
Read on.
As if a man did flee from a lion.
It's going to be like you fled from a lion. You try to run from this camp and that camp, and I don't want to be around no camps. I'll do it on my own. You ran from the camps, and you ran into a lion. You ran into a bear. You understand? You ran from one, what you thought was evil or what you thought was dangerous. You ran from your own people, went off to the so-called white man because you didn't believe he was Esau no more. And you flee to the lion, man.
Right, right.
You try to run from camp life, and you sat in your house all day on the computer and caught a heart attack off of being fat and not doing nothing.
Right,
you know
right.
what I mean? You ran from one, from what you thought was evil, and ran right into real evil. And that's what's going to happen when you desire that day of the Most High, when you think you get to double dutch and play with the word of the Most High and obeying him. But read on.
And a bear met him.
Go ahead.
Or went into the house and leaned his hand on the wall.
Right. When do you do that? You go in the house and lean your hand on the wall. Why? Because you think you're safe.
Right.
You know what I mean? You think you're, oh, I'm good. Whew, I'm on base.
Right, right.
Read.
And a serpent bit him.
And a serpent bit him. So there ain't going to be nowhere for you to run. You ain't going to get to go home and you think you in your house kicking it. Just like Mordecai told Esther back in the day. He said, don't think because you're living in the king's house that you're going to be safe.
Right.
That decree is coming down on all Israel.
Right,
and
right.
It's the same days right now. Is that decree is coming down on all Israel. These cops don't give a damn if you IUIC, GOCC, ISUPK, whatever alphabet soup you put in front of your Hebrew name. They don't care. They're going to shoot you down for being black in the wrong neighborhood, brown in the wrong neighborhood.
Right, but do we have the unity?
Exactly.
But we come together and at least eat together.
Right.
You know what I mean? Drink together.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's why they couldn't touch, they couldn't touch the NOI, the Nation of Islam, back in the day.
Right.
They couldn't touch them because they were unified.
Right.
It was all out there in their bow ties, and they was making sure that, okay, whether we come out here with guns or we come out here without guns, there's so many of us, you ain't gonna have enough bullets to stop all of us.
Right, right.
You know what I mean? There's so many of us unified and thinking like this that you're gonna have to mow down a bunch of brothers in the street and show that to the world. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And we're just gonna end up being martyrs for somebody else to rise up and be angry.
Right.
But and that presented a threat to the establishment.
Right.
You know what I mean? So what did they do? The enemy sowed tares and broke up that unity.
Yeah,
man.
And that's what you look at the Nation of Israel, man. The most Satan is doing.
Oh, yeah.
He's coming in trying to be that one, that guy in the front right there trying to divide. He's trying to divide the power.
Right.
You know what I mean? And that's what they're doing. They're on the YouTube. They're dealing with the zeitgeist. They're dealing with the Egyptology. They're dealing with some Edomite knowledge instead of the knowledge of the Most High.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Or they're trying to engraft some part of Christianity into the doctrine instead of following the knowledge.
Right. And it's, you know, anything to be, I'm not going to be up under no man, or I'm going to research for myself. Well, that's cool. But you're going to go home thinking you're safe in your little knowledge bank that you got at your house, and you're going to lean on the wall, and a serpent going to bite you. Right. You know what I mean? You're going to be in the, you're going to be away from that brotherhood when they all gathered together in that right spot where the Spirit led them in unity.
Right.
And you're going to be sitting there alone, and the Most High going to get you there.
You know what? And that's perfect, because even, you know, I'm sure you brothers and sisters are familiar with it. Acts, the second chapter. When did they get the gift of the Holy Spirit? It was only through them coming together in unity, one mind, one accord. That's when the Spirit came.
Right.
You know, a lot of brothers and sisters don't want to know why they ain't got the spiritual power. Well, one, because it's not going to happen during this time. And two is because, look at us.
Yeah.
Look at us, man.
Too divided.
Why? Because you still have that slavery. Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter, thy eye shall be evil against thy brother mentality.
Yep.
You know, instead of understanding, no, brother, that's my brother.
Right.
You know what I mean? That's my nation.
Right. Yep. Go from there. Go to Romans chapter 13, and we're going to start at verse 11. Because this is what our people got to do. We got to start waking up. We got to start seeing it's getting so detrimental when that day of the Most High comes in, it's darkness and not light. Mm-hmm. And when it comes and it's all these dangers and all these perils, the last thing on your mind is going to be how correct you got the breakdown, or how the next brother next to you ain't speaking the Hebrew correctly. You know what I mean? Like, why are you saying Yahweh and I'm saying Yahweh? You ain't going to be thinking about that. And so what you need to do, the purpose of this show was to get your mind off of that BS that y'all on, man. That's the stuff that Christ going to come back and in the twinkling of an eye, he's going to change that.
Yeah.
Or you think the Most High is going to have an imperfect nation kingdom when he sets everything down? So, like I said, just for because I want to amalgamate everybody in there. You don't believe in Christ in the New Testament? Cool. We'll keep it Old Testament. He said he's going to gather them together
right, in
the Valley of Jehoshaphat. You think he's going to keep them there in division? No, he's going to gather them in unity too.
Right, right.
And he's going to change all them little bickerings and give the truth out and disseminate that knowledge and say, you know what, this was the real knowledge.
Right,
kill all that.
And you know what's powerful on that? Man, this is beautiful. But it goes back to, oh, you know what, we are solidified. And you know what, there is no other body, nobody else has the truth but us.
Right.
We know in part and we prophesy in part. So how does that pan out now?
Right.
You know what I mean? So it's showing you that there's going to be little things that we don't know.
Right.
That we do have to come together in unity and be able to talk about it and sit down and be able to say, well, show me that. I didn't see it that way.
Right, right.
You know what I mean? But brothers, they're on this, you know what? No, I got the truth. That's what it is. But it's funny because everybody thinks that.
Right.
You know, right?
Yeah.
Everybody thinks that, right?
Yeah, they all think they got it all.
Everybody thinks they got it all.
Right.
But we don't have it all. Right. We don't have it all. The scriptures say it. We know in part and we prophesy in part. Right, exactly. So if we had it all, then why is he going to come in a twinkling of an eye and change us? Why is he going to, that which is in part, when he come, is going to be done away with?
Right.
Why is it all going to be edified then? Because we don't have it all. But the Most High is playing those brothers and sisters that think like that. You know why? Because how did you treat your brother? Did you clothe them? Did you feed them? Did you visit them in prison? Or were you just this rebel? Just, you know what? No, I'm cutting everybody off. You're off. You're wicked. You're like, okay, you're wicked too. We're all wicked.
Right, right.
Like, you can't, like, we all can play games. You know what I mean? Like, it says none is righteous.
Right.
So even though if you think you're doing, you got all the breakdowns, you got all the scriptures, you're still not better than me and I'm not better than you.
Right.
Because we all fall short. Right.
Yep.
So even from that perspective, brothers should get it. Like, I don't got it all. Right. I can't have it all. All is not in the sons of man. We can't receive it all.
Right.
Right.
Yep. And I mean, even this divided mentality.
Yeah.
Is why the law had to come.
There you go.
To put everybody, you know what? Everybody's going to think the same way.
Right, right.
You know what I mean? Yeah, ain't none of y'all righteous. Y'all all thinking on your own things.
Right.
You came out of Egypt that had over 1 million gods. You know what I mean? Y'all thinking the famous ones, but yeah, they had over 1 million gods and they couldn't be on one mind state about which one they were going to serve.
Right, right.
And we came out of that. And so the Most High laid the law down. He said, listen, I'm gonna make everybody equal.
Right.
Everyone's gonna follow this law. Everyone's gonna do righteousness the way I say it.
Mm-hmm.
The way Moses brings it down to you, that's how you're gonna become righteous. That's how you're gonna do righteousness now.
Right.
You know what I mean? And we're in that mentality now, coming out of America. And when he comes, he's gonna go ahead and set that all the same way too.
Right. Right.
Again, but right now, what we should be knowing is we're not just striving to get to the law part. Again, we're trying to strive to get to that original, that every man was righteous. We all were fully persuaded in our own mind.
Right. It's all through the scriptures, man. Go to John. When you go back to John, he said, it's the spirit that quickeneth.
There you go.
He said, the flesh profiteth nothing. We know that. You know, the scriptures say the law is spiritual.
Right.
Tells you in Romans, the law is spiritual.
Right.
So, but we are carnal and we never understood the law. So, I mean, the thing is that there's a lot of older brothers that are overlooking and they're forgetting.
Right.
You know what I mean? And a lot of the new generation, they have not yet even read it or understood it.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? So, you know, which would alleviate a lot of this confusion is what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Like if you got in there and you understood the dynamics of how this Bible is written, brother, the scriptures tell you itself it's a stumbling block.
Right.
It's a stumbling stone.
Yeah.
So that we may fall back on it. So it's deeper than we think. Everybody thinks it's going to be on point, strict, trick. No, it ain't.
Right, right.
You know?
Yeah. Read that. Romans 13:11.
Romans chapter 13, verse 11. And that, knowing the time.
Knowing what?
Knowing the time.
Having some knowledge.
Knowing the time.
Knowing the breakdowns.
Knowing the time.
He said knowing the time. Go ahead.
That now it is high time to awake out of sleep.
Now it's time to wake up, man. Now it's time to stop dreaming. Now it's time to stop acting and faking and living in some dream world that, oh, I'm a Hebrew Israelite because I have some knowledge in my hand, because I have a Bible in my hand, or I grew my beard out. No, now knowing the time, now it's time to wake up out of sleep. And what do you do after you wake up? That's when you begin to act. That's when you start your day. That's when you start moving around and working. So he wants us to know the time, that it's not time for us to slumber. It's not time for us to lay down. It's not time for us to get our little knowledge bank up and just sit down and do nothing. He said, know the time, read.
For now is our salvation nearer than when we believe.
Our salvation, the salvation that belongs to Israel. Salvation is of the Jews, if you want to go by the words of Christ right there. The salvation that's coming to Israel, it's nearer than when you believed.
Mm-hmm.
And it's coming, so you can't wait for that last time, the day of the Most High. You gotta know now that salvation to Israel is coming, and it's soon. And we got to work as if that can come at any second. Read on.
Verse 12. The night is far spent.
Go ahead.
The day is at hand.
Right.
Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness.
We got to cast off the works of darkness. Bickering, fighting, strife, confusion, complaining, murmuring.
Right.
Those are the works of darkness.
Right. We should already be past understanding that you know you're not supposed to be a homosexual, a drug dealer, a killer, a murderer.
Right.
You know, the scriptures make it plain. All unrighteousness shall not inherit the kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
It tells us that in 1 Corinthians, what, 6 chapter, right?
Right.
So we should understand that.
Right.
You know what I mean? That what the law says in the basics.
Right. See that?
But it don't say because you didn't have this breakdown.
Right.
Or you lacked understanding in this scripture. This is not what that's not going to save our spirit, our soul.
Right, right.
And that's where we go back to the baptism.
Yeah.
That's where we go back to the, you know, sort of the same thing Nicodemus asked. Well, how do we be born again?
Right.
You know what I mean? It's the same mentality as, oh, you got to be dunked in water. You could dunk yourself in water 1,000 times. If you're a homosexual, it's not going to wash off the homosexuality.
Right. Right.
You know, if you got pride demons, lust demons on you, and you're getting dunked in that water, that ain't going to save you when you come out the water. What's going to save you is your conscience being changed.
Right. Right.
And that's what it all comes down to. Why am I saying that? Because when we go back to the breakdowns, you can have the breakdown all you want, but is that going to save you? No, it's not.
Hmm.
It's not going to save you.
Exactly.
You know, just like those things in the law.
Right.
You know what I mean? That we don't understand.
Right.
You know, that brothers and sisters don't understand that. Oh, you know what? I don't eat pork, brother. You know what I mean? I don't eat pork. Oh, yay. I follow the Sabbath. No, you don't.
Right.
You don't. You really don't.
Right.
You think you do. but you don't. You know what I mean? Or I follow the laws. Really? You follow all the laws? So you're perfect in the law, right? You don't got no mixed cloth, right? When's the last time you dealt with a harlot and you trying to be a priest?
Right.
You know, we were talking about that in Sabbath class. It says for a priest couldn't be a, he couldn't marry a harlot.
Right.
You know what I mean? So what I'm saying
is.
He
had to marry a virgin. Huh? He had to marry a virgin,
right?
Woman. Yeah.
That's in the law.
Right.
You know what I mean? So knowledge puffeth up, but charity edifieth.
Yeah.
Because, you know, what is
charity's gonna understand? You ain't finding no virgins no more. You know what I mean?
What is gonna get us prepared for this destruction?
Right.
This chaos is coming down.
Right. Like brothers running around talking about, I'm gonna marry a 9-year-old, and like, really? How's that 9-year-old gonna help you when you need to get bullets? You know what I mean? How's your little elementary school wife how's she gonna help you in the last days? You know what I mean? She can't even get a job nowhere.
You get to that level, that's not a brother.
Or, you know what I mean? Or I could rape women. Like, what? That's what your mind is on right now while we got brothers getting shot down in the streets.
Listen, we're already talking about things that we already understand.
Like, right, right.
Unrighteousness shall not inherit the kingdom. That's right. What level we're talking on with brothers.
Right.
As far as the murderers, fornicators, rapists, the most, come on, that's on a whole nother level. You're bordering the sinning to wicked.
Right, right.
You know what I mean? When you think you can do stuff like that.
Right, right. And, you know, that's the thing is, the reason I brought that out is because they're trying to prove it with scripture. And that's the thing is, like, this is your number one priority right now.
Right.
Is that, you know, whether you can have sex with a 9-year-old girl or not, or whether you can rape a woman or not, when we got, again, brothers getting shot up in the streets.
Yeah.
Brothers are dying. Sisters are dying left and right at the hands of the enemy.
Right.
You know what I mean? But the enemy got you some knowledge that you just chewed on like a dog on a bone. And you ain't even worried about guarding the fence no more. You ain't worried about guarding the gates. You gnawing on your bones. You know what I mean? You chewing on dead works when we gotta wake up.
Let alone, you should, as much as knowledge you supposed to have, you know you can't rape women.
Right.
Come on now. I mean, that's
it's not even righteous. It's not.
Yeah, it's not righteous. You know what I mean? But go ahead, I.
No, read where you're at, I.
Romans chapter 13, the end of verse 12.
Go ahead.
And let us put on the armor of light.
That's what we're supposed to be putting on, man. The armor of being illuminated, man. The armor of being knowledgeable of the scriptures, being lit up by that knowledge. And those kind of works are not being lit up by the knowledge.
The best that we can, because as we're finding this knowledge, you know what I mean, coming from the world, you know, I'm coming out of drugs, homosexuality, coming back to the Most High in Christ and putting on this armor.
Right.
You know what I mean? You got to take hold of this quick.
Exactly.
Yeah. You got to take hold of it quick, because right now it's being stripped from a lot of these young brothers and sisters. Yeah. And now when they're getting it, they're just getting
confusion.
Yeah, they're just in chaos.
You don't need a camp. You don't need to gather together. You don't. It's like, come on, man. All the scriptures from Genesis to Exodus, I mean Genesis to Revelation say that. You know what I mean?
The love, the brotherhood, the unity. All these things are being ripped apart by. You know what I mean? Their so-called knowledge.
Yeah, yeah. It was brought in by the enemy, perpetuated by brothers that joined with the enemy, and now they're giving it to these new cats, like Pharisees, man. They just preventing them from getting in the kingdom.
Yeah.
You know? And that's the thing. This is the time that he's saying, knowing this time, forget all that. You know what I mean? When the Most High comes, when Christ comes, the decree that's going to come forth is not going to be based on whether you know how to say Khan or Ken in Hebrew.
Right.
Or, you know, whether you knew how to say Yahweh, Ahaya, Yeshua, or whatever in Hebrew. It's not going to come down to that. That's not going to stop the decree from coming
forth. And this is, let me say this for all the simple-minded comments that we're going to get. So, first of all, what we're saying is that we're talking to brothers and sisters that know the knowledge.
Right.
You know what I mean? That understand what we're dealing with. But there's a step, you know what I mean, which is letting go of that worldly mentality, that worldly mind, and those worldly sins.
Right.
So we're in no way saying that, oh, now you don't supposed to put on this knowledge.
Right.
We're saying contrary. We're saying that we have to understand that putting on this knowledge is not based off of you having a breakdown and you getting that on point. That's not going to save you.
Right. Why are you learning the knowledge is for love, for love's sake.
There you go.
I want to teach my brother, teach my
there
sister,
you go.
Get them on point.
There you go. Just to get that out the way, because you know you got the simple mind. So we, the scriptures say, we know what the scripture says.
Yeah, those are the same
if
ones getting caught up
in
call.
If they speak not according to this law, this word, there's no light in them.
Exactly.
So we know what the scriptures say about the commandments, about the following, but about following the commandments. But what we're saying is, and we're trying to give understanding on, is that you're letting knowledge oppose what the spiritual man is supposed to be doing.
Right.
You know, you're thinking that, you know, just because you know Christ is black, now you can go ahead and still be that prideful, lustful, hateful person. No. You know what I mean? Right. You can't use that. And this is what Paul was talking about when you deal with the law.
Exactly.
And you deal with the spirituality of the law.
Right. Like, you know, it's like I'm looking at brothers trying to prove that these Africans in East Sudan and all this are Israelites. But you don't live in Africa. You don't know any Africans. You're just going against knowledge that's been out just to do it.
What about the brothers? That's right. Like Oprah Winfrey going out and setting up schools out there. Like, what about the brothers and sisters here that's hurting?
Right.
That's in the ghettos, in the slums.
Right.
The one we know, you know, and there might be brothers and sisters out there. You know, just like, you know, me and Preacher Shia talk about, he's edifying on, you know, the Chinese or Israelites.
Right, right.
Okay, I can see Israelites out there in China. The scriptures say we're scattered through
everywhere.
The four corners of the earth. Right.
Yep.
But are we in China yet? Are we in Africa yet?
Right.
You know what I mean? But the ones we're getting, the ones that are here, yeah, brother, you know what? You think you're Chinese, but guess what? You're Israelite.
Right.
You know what I mean? You think you're African or Sudanese or whatever, but you might be an Israelite is what I'm saying.
Right.
Go back, because we went over that ourselves. You know, you got white people that think they're white because their mom is white.
Right.
But their dad is straight Negro.
Right.
They're Israelites. Fine. But that's the love.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Yeah. Reaching our people. You know what I mean? Getting our people, gathering them together, and getting prepared for what the heck is finna happen to this world.
Right. I mean, brothers and sisters seem to forget in Old and New Testament, the righteous had this mindset. If you were Abraham, you didn't care what nation you was dealing with. You know what I mean? You went there, you taught them, you did this, you did that, you traded with them, whatever. Right? It wasn't about the nationality thing. Mm-hmm. Well, you dealt with Paul. I wish that all men could be saved. You know, it's like, that's what a righteous man's thinking, because who wants the Most High to nuke anybody?
Right, right.
Who wants to see that? You know,
right,
like,
right.
I don't want to see somebody's eyes consumed in their holes. That's not daytime television for me. You know what I mean? Now, we want revenge for our enemies,
you know,
for the things that are done.
Right, and it's going to happen.
Right.
That's going to happen without us, whether we want to or not.
Right.
The nations are going to be punished because they got it coming to them. You reap what you sow.
Mm-hmm.
That's without a doubt. But perfect, because me and Yeshua was talking about that too, about David. You know, and when he went and hid himself, who did he go to?
He went to the nations, right?
He went to the nations. You know, he didn't go over there and telling them, oh, you filthy ass, you dirty ass Africans.
Right,
he went
right.
over there and he built a relationship with them.
Yeah.
These were heathens.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Because he dealt with wisdom.
Yeah, they're forgetting how the temple was built. We
right.
Trading with the man from Tyre and Zidon. We was trading with them.
There you go.
So,
there you go. And like, all these instances that we dealt with the other nations with wisdom and with understanding. We didn't just run out there and say, you filthy, disgusting bastards. We dealt with wisdom and knowledge.
Right.
We traded with them.
Right.
Just like you said, you know?
I mean, the Most High sent Jonah to Nineveh for all that. You know what I mean? He told them they had
a
chance to get right.
I think you might be
going
too deep there.
Right, right. But they had a chance to get right, you know, after all their wickedness. That was a whole nother nation.
Right.
So,
Sodom and Gomorrah.
Right. Clearly the righteousness was a man that wanted life for everybody.
Right,
you know what I mean? He wanted everyone to be able to live, because he knew the Most High had set them down here for a reason.
Right.
And that was the plan of the Most High
could
that
I,
they be.
Could I throw the disclaimer in there to the simple mind? We're not saying that the nations ain't going to get punished.
Right.
We're not saying they're not going to be in captivity, because that's what the Most High promised because of their disobedience.
Right.
But what we're saying is that our character is supposed to be the utmost standard of the Most High.
Right.
That how we supposed to be carrying ourselves.
Yeah.
We don't supposed to be running out there. We're like we say on the street speaking, we're not worried about the white man, and we're not worried about, you know what I mean, them being the evil, deceiving, deceptive people.
Right.
We're out there teaching our people.
Right.
You know what I mean? We don't got time for the whole 13 hours to yell at the so-called white man.
Right, right.
You know what I mean? We don't got time for that. We got time to wake up the niggas in the hood that's selling crack to their own mama.
Right.
You know, that's important to us.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? I think we forget that. Yeah. We're forgetting that when we get come in the truth, we put on the fringes, we grow the beards, and then it's like, you know what? The same people you came to save, you know what I mean? That's when you want to cut them off. You know?
Let me get this last scripture. Okay. Hebrews 12, verse 1.
Okay.
I want you to read that real fast. We got a minute. We got 1 minute. All right. Go ahead and read that.
Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Wherefore, seeing we also are compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses.
Go ahead.
So let us lay aside every weight and the sin which do so easily beset us.
Right. Let me say this, brothers and sisters. If we cut off, we thank y'all for tuning in. For YouTube, we're going to go on just a little more and further edify on this topic. And we like to say shalom to everybody that is live. Shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom. Shalom.
Okay, go ahead.
And let us run with patience unto the race that is set before us.
Right. So what he wants us to do, what we're commanded to do, is lay aside every weight. And these things are weights, man. When you look at what's keeping us from the unity, it's something holding us back. That's the same thing you had in religion. You didn't go with the Catholics because they believed in this or they believed in that. You're doing the same thing in Israel. You're letting weights hold you back. Mm-hmm. Oh, this man says Yahweh, I say Ahaya, so I'm over here and he's over there and I will never help him out. And I'm going to let him die alone and live alone and not care about his family and not care about his kids. That's religion. We got to lay aside the weight. Mm. And what else? Lay aside every weight and what?
And the sin which do so easily beset us.
And the sin, the bickering, the strife, the contention. Those are all sins.
Yeah.
We gotta let that go because it's besetting us. It's taking us off of the path.
Right, right.
See that? Read on.
Verse 2.
Oh, no. And let us what?
And let us run with patience unto the race that is set before us.
Right, let's run with patience the race that's set before us, not the other side tracks, not the other bickering and complaining. And, hey, you know what, I'm running this race, but, oh, they got the wrong colors on the sidelines. I'm going to go deal with them real quick. Mm-hmm. No, you don't do that in a race. You run for the mark. And that's what we need to do as Israelites, as a people, is run and press toward that mark and stop getting caught up with things that weigh us apart.
Right, right.
And the sin, you know what I mean? The sin of disunity, of disassembling, you know what I mean? Of being on my own, I'm contrary. The loner, contrary, there you go. Mm. You know what I mean? These kind of things, we got to lay that stuff aside.
Yeah, there's a lot of that. I just want to be contrary just to do that.
Right, right, right.
You know? Uh-oh. So, I mean, I know we got a lot more. We can always go back into this topic for brothers and sisters on YouTube, and we're going to probably do that, do a second part show to get out a lot more of those scriptures.
Right, right.
But with that, we're going to say shalom to everybody. And brothers and sisters, check us out. Check out our other shows. We have a lot of other shows on there, a lot of other topics y'all can check out on YouTube, ISBHPK. And
Ustream.
And check out our Ustream. Our Ustream also has a lot of class shows on there. If you want to go into a little more in depth, if you have a larger attention span than an hour, you can go on there and check out our Ustream shows. But with that, the Israelite School of Biblical History and Practical Knowledge, we'd like to say shalom.
Shalom. Shalom.